I'm Wayne Hartley. I'm the Manatee Specialist with Save Manatee Club. And we're going to go out here in the next 15 minutes and have a look at the daily life of manatees. There are times when we go out in the canoe and see over 400 manatees in a single morning. Blue Springs is a protected winter warm water site and a vital sanctuary where manatees can rest and stay warm without fear of being hit by boats. Manatees are slow-moving animals. They prefer waters about 3 to 7 feet deep. Manatees swim through the water by moving their paddle-shaped tail up and down. On average, manatees swim between 3 to 5 miles per hour. Manatees use their flippers for steering, crawling along the bottom, and holding food. Manatees rest for about 2 to 12 hours per day. Manatees may rest submerged on the bottom or just below the surface of the water. Manatees spend about 6 to 8 hours per day feeding. Manatees are herbivores, which means they only eat plants. On average, manatees eat 100 to 150 pounds of food each day. Manatees graze along the bottom and on the surface of the water. Being mammals, manatees must surface to breathe air. On average, manatees come up to breathe air every 3 to 5 minutes. If really active, they can come up for air every 30 seconds. A resting manatee can hold its breath for up to 20 minutes. Manatees can be quite playful. They do barrel rolls, tail stands, head stands, and upside down gliding. Manatees are not territorial animals. They are semi-social, somewhat solitary animals. Having few natural enemies, manatees don't need the protection of a herd. Manatee gatherings are usually because of common habitat requirements, such as warm water, fresh water, or food sources. Unfortunately, many manatee bear scars from encounters with motorboats. We actually use these scars to identify individual manatees. We have scar pattern charts, which are backed up by photographs. Photographs are really better, but scar pattern charts, I can carry all 300 animals out there in the canoe with me on the paper. And to do the life history, you have to re-recognize the animals, and that's what it's all about, is these scars. And we have fingerprints, manatees have scar patterns, but every year we have to go out and redraw and re-photograph because they've got new scars, old scars have healed and changed. So you just have to keep it up year after year after year to even determine how long a particular manatee lives. If you protect manatees, you protect so many other things, and especially the seagrass beds and the habitat needed, not just for manatees, but for the small fish to grow and for your sport fishing and your commercial fishing industries to survive, along with all the other little animals that depend on these things to survive. So if you protect manatees, you're protecting a whole lot more than just manatees.